Tom Lee, Funstrat's Tom Lee, noting that in the last six instances when we've seen a 35% decline from all-time highs and you've recovered at least 62% of the losses, you've never seen the market dip back below that 50% retracement level. That would be 2794 on the S&P 500 right now. We're still holding above 3,000. So what's your take? Are we actually out of the woods here? Are you finally calling this a new bull market?
Well, I've been very, very bullish since I've been on your show the last couple of months, which makes me look pretty good right now, Zach. But I digress. I have to agree with Tom Lee on that. I think if you look at it, we've never retraced that far back. There are tremendous odds in your favor as a bull. And he's been right on as well. He's been very bullish here. And there's not many of us that have called for a V-shaped recovery. My firm's one of them. And I just think when you have this much liquidity, I learned this back in 08, 09, and you have this much pessimism and this much money sitting in the sidelines with cash, man, this is like rocket fuel for a bull market, which we're already in, by the way.
But when you're looking at the stocks now, I mean, we've seen some recovery from the tech sector giving back a little bit today. So where exactly are you putting money to work if you do believe that you're out from the worst of it now? What would be the new leader to take over from here?
Yeah, I think you got to be careful here. Don't just buy the obvious trade. It's like, yes, we know Zoom is up because we're home quarantine right now. We know grocery stocks are up. It's like, that's very obvious. And the market's already bidded those type of stocks up. And the list goes on and on and on. But we have to start thinking about is the economy is starting to recover. The market's already telling you that. What does it look like when the market recovers? You know, more people are driving, more people are flying, manufacturing picks up, production picks up. Well, that means higher oil prices, right? So things like energy, which have just gotten hammered here, they have much more runway on the upside here. Financials, if you get reacceleration of global growth, you start to see interest rates go up. That means their net interest margins go up. So I think the really smart money right now, and what we're doing for our client base, is we're allocating across the board internationally, value stocks, all the things that are still pretty beat up. Don't just buy the S&P. It's a tech fund and drag at this point. That's what we like to call it anyway.
Are you seeing this as more of kind of like a slow from here on out, now that we've gotten it, a slower recovery where money starts to trickle in? Because there is, as you've noted, not a lot of people who enjoyed the latest rally. So, I mean, FOMO does start to weigh on the minds of investors out there. So how do you see it playing out from here?
Yeah, I think the problem is there's not enough FOMO. I think, you know, we mentioned investors took $1 trillion out of the market. A lot of these money managers, which always underperform, by the way, just, you know, put that out there, is they're sitting in cash and, you know, you have this thesis of, oh, the market's definitely going back down. You know, the economy is going to have a, you know, double dip recession. Sometime in the fall, we're going to get a resurgence of this virus. It's common knowledge. Everybody thinks that everybody's sitting in cash. So that means everybody's looking for a dip. And that's why every dip's been so shallow, because that cash has to get back in the market. So I can see the market continually melting up from here, not a slow rise, just because there's so much cash they have to get in right now. There's so much pressure, Zach, on the upside that your risk right now is not being in. It's not sitting on the sidelines with protection.
So let's talk a little bit more about those risks too, because I don't want to fully overlook them, because we had Dan Niles, the Tory fund manager, on the show yesterday highlighting he's been one of those who's kind of taken the other side, been a little bit more cautious than you and Tom have, talking about the risks out there. And one of the newer ones that I talked about on the open here was U.S.-China tensions. He noted back in 2018, we saw the market fall off to wrap up the year, if you remember what it was like over the holiday back then. Once the U.S.-China trade development started to unravel, and we're kind of seeing that now. So I would say there's some historical context in terms of investors actually caring about that. So, I mean, is that the biggest risk you see to having this maybe give back a bit of the gains that we've had?
Wow. Yeah, I think so little about the downside right now, because I'm so afraid of missing the upside. But just a comment on China there, Zach. I mean, I think that was last year, right? Last year, we already had trade tension. We already know the U.S. doesn't approve what's happening in Hong Kong, and the market was up over 30%. So I'm going to go on a limb here and say it's probably a non-event again in 2020. But what you really want to focus on is the fact that you literally have the government throwing $9 trillion at the problem, and they're doing that. So this thing just like does not fail. And that doesn't even factor in central banks around the world, which have done like a $6 trillion asset buying program. So I think it's just like everything is rigged to make this thing go higher and the economy is to stabilize. So I can't even, unless it's like the pandemic comes in worse than expected come the fall or something like that, I just think there's just too many cards stacked against you to have the market go down here with any sort of significant correction.